What's up, Final Community? Cliff the Bottle Cheapskate here. Coming at you with a Saturday coffee music. So, second half of my vinyl finds. This is mostly budget finds. All these records that I have were under 10 bucks. Some were cheaper than others. I've got a huge stack of 99 of records that I got four for a dollar, quarter each. So I'm going to do a flip through of these and not really talk about them at the end. So I'll talk about a couple of the ones I got. These are all basically all shop pickups. There's one that I forgot that it was an online pickup. But yeah, this is one of my budget big finds right here. The Motors, that's what we're listening to in the background. Good, kind of like fast, poppy rock and roll music. Falls into new wave, kind of. I think they got lumped into the early punk, with the early punk bands. Early British punk bands. But this is really good on Virgin Records. Came out in 77. Good, just like power poppy stuff. So, that's what we're listening to. I'll just put that back there. My cats are down here, so they may pop in and say hello. Here, let's see. Over there. There they are. Beating each other up. Anyway, the one that I got online that I forgot to put in, there's a couple in here that should have went in my metal and punk ones, but that's alright. They're still cheapies, and they were from the shops. But, Frank Zappa, Chugga's Revenge, first one I'm going to show. What can I say? It's Frank Zappa I didn't have. Great stuff. It's one of his earlier ones, I believe. I think it's 70s? No, 1970. So, excellent stuff. Frank Zappa just does no wrong, really. So, you can't go wrong with Frank Zappa. It's a nice gatefold. Show you the whole thing. Why not? The Buddha inner sleeve is in there, but they put it in a plain paper sleeve too. Nice copy. This is kind of an add-on to one of the Sham 69 records I showed last time. But yeah, it came with the printed inner. Definitely decent. Well worth picking up. And like I said, everything was less than 10 bucks. I think this was a $7 record. I think it was online. I don't remember. I think I paid 7 bucks for it. And I kind of tacked it on with the... because it was one that I wanted. Price was right. And it said very good plus on the vinyl. So, gotta take that. Now, the rest of these are all from shops. First stack is... all from Sondios Records, which is one of my spots, and it was, this Motors record was in this stack, came from Sondios, it was one of my budget bin finds. This one wasn't budget, but it was cheap, I think it was 7 bucks as well, but Crocus Headhunter, cheap metal, this is a good record. There's a couple stinkers on here, but the song Headhunter, Screaming in the Night, and Russian Winter, those three tracks alone make this well worth picking up. More on the hard rock end of the heavy metal spectrum, but there's some heavy metal licks in there. Sounds kind of like a European AC/DC sort of, most of their stuff. But yeah, really good record. Can't complain. Artista. Version. I don't know exactly what press this is. Came out in 83. Excellent stuff, though. I like this record a lot. I can't speak for many of the other Crocus records. I've only really heard this one. Let me know if I should check out more of their stuff, but this is one that I heard and that has stuck with me, and I really liked it. I never really deep dove into Crocus. Or Crocus. I've only listened to that one Crocus record. another Blackfoot record, Kings of the Budget Bin, probably the best budget bin rock you can find. Blackfoot, great hard rock from the 70s, a little country rock mixed in. There's also some heavy metal licks on these, some early metal sounding stuff. This is from 1980, I think. 1976. Yeah, this one's 1976, so late 70s rock stuff, but very good. This is way overlooked, I think. Another one, Blood Rock, more 70s hard rock. This is kind of an upgrade copy. I already have a copy of this, but it's a little warped. So found this in the budget bin. I'm going to see if it's any better than the one I've got, and go from there. Blood Rock 3. And like I said, the Motors record back there was also one of the budget bin finds. Next up, this is all stuff from the Sun, from the Wax Atlas sale. Wax Atlas, one of my local shops, was moving. They had a moving sale. So they were doing 20% off all the records in the store. Basically 20% off everything in the store. And they had buy four for a dollar. That's what it was. Four for a dollar budget room title. So they have a whole budget room that's usually a dollar room, and they're selling all that for a quarter, which is where this giant stack right here is. And like I said, I'm just going to do like a flip through type video at the end of this so you can see what's in here. Alright, this one was a free bin find, actually. He also has free bins, and he was just filling them with stuff from the dollar room because he wanted to get rid of it. But I picked up this Gospel Oak record, and literally only because this guy, these guys' coats right here, and what the band looked like, I figured it can't be that bad. And you know what? I listened to it. Pretty good shit. It's like, just like classic rock type stuff, little hard rocky, little blues rock in there, but what these guys, I read these guys were sample copies, so it's a promo, baby. But yeah, just picked it up in the free bin just because of what the dudes look like, and it sounds like these guys look, so that's all I really wanted from it. Good record. Great, good songwriting, fun tunes. I enjoyed it. It's a little cap label. This is, and it's in like perfect condition. It's got the cap inner sleeve here. Yeah, this was a cool record. Cool find for free. The only one I took from the free bin, I didn't have time. I went to help him move. I picked this up while I was there because it was right on top, and I didn't have time to flip through the free stuff, so I only ended up with that one. But these are the ones that I paid regular price, not regular price, but the 20% off on. And I'll start off with this one. This one also should have went in the punk and hardcore one last year, but Butcher. This is great, like metallic, punk, hardcore stuff. Really fucking good. It's a 45. It's got $18.99 on there, but it was only $5 on the other label. But this is really good, like punky, hardcore, a lot of thrash bits in here. Kind of crusty. Very fucking good. Modernish stuff. I think this came out in 2020. Desolate Records, Metronome DB with ripping guitar licks. You can't go wrong with that, in my opinion. There's the labels, got some custom labels. It's got this lyric sheet here, and that's it. Another one. This is a weird one. The Gods. Third Testament. This is a repress of some sort. Get Back repress. I'm not sure exactly when that's from. Via the Netherlands. But yeah, this is like a folk psych group. The Gods. I know there's another Gods that's like a hard rock group. This is the folk psych group, so they just do really weird stuff. My wife actually made me turn this off. She said it was giving her anxiety. So, but yeah, really excellent, kind of like mind-bending folk psych stuff. It's a fun one. Check it out if you like weirdo folk stuff. More poppy folk stuff. This is really good, kind of like in the Beatles vein type of pop psych stuff. Colors on Dot Records, the Paramount Dot label. But this is a fun one. I really enjoyed this record. Really good songwriting, good tunes, kind of like garagey pop psych stuff. I've been getting a little more into that stuff, but it's got to be a certain type. I saw somebody post this before, but this was also a $5 fine, so couldn't go wrong with it. But yeah, really fun band. Really fun little record right there. Some wacky prog rock stuff. Omega. Omega is just a prog rock band on Passport, same label as the as Lucifer's Friend and stuff. I think there's a little hard rock, pop rock. I haven't listened to this yet. I kind of picked this up because I've seen it around. It's got a cool cover, and it was $5, so I figured I'd check it out. Haven't really listened. Actually, it was $3. Now I'm looking at the sleeve. It was not $5. It was $3. So that's why I grabbed that thing. $3. Picked up this Members record. This is a really good kind of new wave record. New wave, power pop, a little bit of ska in there too. Great stuff. This is a really fun record. Working Girl, The Model, Chairman of the Board. This is just excellent all the way through. Really cool stuff. It looks a little punkier than it actually is. It's a lot more pop. But definitely a fun record. Came with the inner sleeve. Artista Records again. And this one's a throwback too, because it's got one of my old... one of the shops I used to go to back in the day in Philly. It came from Repo Records in Philadelphia originally. I ended up in Wax Atlas somehow, and then ended up in my record collection now. And last but not least is Marcel. This is a... I think these guys are French, but they play kind of like a new wave of British heavy metal style music. Came out in 1979, I believe this came out. It doesn't say on here, but yeah, 79. So it was early. There's some metal leaning, early metal leanings in here. It's a hard rock band for sure. A lot of hard rock, 70s hard rock sound in there. But also... mixed in, there is some of that like early new wave of British heavy metal sound in there. This is a sleeper, I think. Great songs. I only listened to it once, but I was definitely like pretty happy with it. I heard of this band and I knew they got lumped in with the new wave of British heavy metal, even though I think they're French. I'm pretty positive that they're French. Mountain Men. I don't know, maybe they're not French, maybe they're American. I have no idea. Let me know in the comments if you know. RCA label. So they were buying into that sound. But yeah, this is great stuff. If you like Saxon and all that early, like late 70s heavy metal stuff, you'll like this too. Definitely check it out. Definitely more on the hard rock side than the heavy metal side. Not a speed metal album or anything, but this is definitely an early one leading into the heavy metal sound. So, and that's it. That's all I got for you. That's the rest of my vinyl finds for June. Like I said, I've got this stack here, and I'm going to just stack it up, and I'll show you what's in the pile. Cheers, everybody. Alright, so the top one's going to be what you're listening to in the background. Modern Jazz Quartet. And these were all quarter each. This is the band name, Fred Frump. I don't know. Tommy James records. I like Tommy James and the Shondells. And that's it.